So, Pap, as we say, you know, the elections are just a couple of days away now. The big issue, of course, is going to be how much of the vote for Democrats comes out. These races are tightening across the country. Just to remind people so that they have a sense of what elections they should be looking at when we're talking about on Tuesday, Republicans need to pick up 6 seats in the Senate to gain control of the Senate. There are 6 Democratic seats that have been more or less in play. We know West Virginia and Montana, those are definitely going to go Republican. Then you've got Arkansas, you've got Alaska, you've got Louisiana, you've got North Carolina. It seems like the Democrats are going to be able to hold on in North Carolina. Kay Hagan doing all right against Tom Tillis. There's been a big Moral Mondays push there for the past couple of years. Tom Tillis was the guy who marshaled these anti-voter laws, essentially, in North Carolina. Arkansas is going to be tough. That's a race that people should be watching.
Arkansas is going to razor blade.
Indeed.
You know, Sam, as you're talking about these races, I think people listening have got they have it in their head now that the Republicans have really done a hell of a job figuring out if they can keep 60,000 voters away from the polls here, 40,000 away here, 100,000 here, that they win in tight races. Every race is razor tight, okay? Think of, you know, Bruce Braley in Iowa, razor tight.
Razor tight. And, you know, that's a race. Braley's got picked up some endorsements. He had some gaffes early in the election. Joni Ernst, she is, you know, more Tea Party than even Ted Cruz. I mean, she's Ted Cruz without the Harvard education.
She's so Tea Party that I'm seeing stories now where she's actually scaring leadership in the national Tea Party organizations because they believe that she becomes the new definition. She becomes the new Michelle Bachmann. She becomes the new Sarah Palin. And so they have to get away from crazy card in order to have any sustainable. Rand Paul's a good example. Rand Paul's understanding he's trying to rebuild the Republican Party in some new image. She scares the hell out of somebody like Rand Paul, even though he may not come out and say it. You can see it. I mean, you can see it in the various reports.
There's a reason why she has avoided going to any editorial board meetings in Iowa. I mean, this is fascinating. I don't know that we've ever seen a Senate candidate who is not an incumbent go into hiding because she's afraid that her stances on issues are actually going to become public knowledge.
And that her ignorance in an interview, I don't know if you followed, she's great on a podium. She's terrible. She is terrible on one-to-one. Because she says such crazy, stupid things. But getting back to your broader question, the Republicans are figuring that it's so razor tight that these efforts keep people away from the polls. I mean, for example, not in a Senate race, but in Texas, you know, 500,000 voters. Understand, 500,000 registered voters now can't vote. In Florida, we're continuing to see efforts to close that margin down. North Carolina, obviously, huge in North Carolina. Arkansas, keep people away from the polls. And so this continued. Well, Wisconsin. Look at what you've got. Scott Walker, that actually by executive order helped pass a law that says that people in voting lines that want to discourage other people from voting can get as close as 3 feet away from them, can take pictures, can do whatever the hell they want to do to discourage voters. That's what this is about right now.
And if Scott Walker, I'll tell you something. If Scott Walker goes down, it's going to be because the Supreme Court struck down the implementation of the Wisconsin voter ID law.
Yes.
And because they were counting on suppressing a lot of those votes out of the Milwaukee area and the Madison area by that very trick. But you've got Alaska. Mark Begich is now up in the polls as of this past week. Now, again, Alaska, very tough to predict what's going on in Alaska because polling is so sparse. But you know, the thing, what people should look for is what happens in Alaska, what happens in Colorado. Mm-hmm. Mark Udall has been down in the polls against this other Tea Party, Gardner. But, you know, again, polling there has very often missed a lot of Latino voters. You also have in Colorado this year, they're mailing everyone ballots. And so this is going to change the likely voter model. Those are important races to watch.
Sam, think about this. You mentioned polling. Do people ever call your cell phone and ask you poll questions? Do they ever ask you, let me poll your cell phone? They call. Look, here's what's happening in the United States. Most people our age and younger, their lifeblood is their telephone, their handheld telephone. So a lot of them don't even have home telephones. You follow what I'm saying?
Yep.
So all of a sudden, this industry that used to be relevant, they used to go out and they would call somebody's house. What do you think? Well, now landlines are in homes that don't reflect the demographics of America. First of all, minorities don't even have, they've moved to where the handheld is the mobile device is what they use. Young people don't even have landlines in their house. Why would they? So all of a sudden you get this skewed number that we're getting out of the polling that I don't think is a reflection of anything. It's the damnedest thing I've ever seen. We now have moved this technological shift and the polling industry hasn't adjusted to it.
Right. And I think, you know, there are some pollsters who are using cell phones, but the bottom line is it's all going to come down to, and people can, you know, if you look at the registered voters polling that goes out there, Democrats are usually up by a couple of points. If you look at the likely voters, they're down by a point or two. And the bottom line is it's going to be driving out the vote. And at ringoffireradio.com, we'll have a link where you can participate in the PCCC's call out the vote program, just a couple of days away. But if you can get in there, you can make some phone calls on behalf of Braley in Iowa and other candidates around the country, because this is all going to be about the vote coming out. In South Dakota,
if you're going to focus on one, it's Braley in Iowa. That's the one to focus on.
But in South Dakota, in Alaska, even in Arkansas, and those are three states where you're going to see minimum wage on the ballot. That may help drive out some voters who could help the Democrats. But the bottom line, again, this is all going to come out to turnout. If the turnout numbers were anywhere close to where they were in 2012, and we know they're not going to be because that's a presidential election, Democrats tend to vote more in those elections. But if they were anywhere close to that, this would be a blowout. You would never see a Republican Senate controlled, a Republican controlled Senate until my 9-year-old girl.
But here's the bad news. The early numbers aren't reflecting that.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. And again, it has been in many respects a function of this incredibly cynical campaign by the Republicans to basically talk about things like Ebola and talk about ISIS and talk about virtually nothing else, the IRS scandal, and on some level, a failure of Democrats to nationalize this around an agenda, even though we know that this agenda is going to be stopped because the Republicans
huge,
in the House are going to block
failure.
Everything.
Huge
you need
failure.
To tell people what you are for.
It sounds like this election is about nothing if you listen to Democrats.